There we go. Start with our bringing our knees up. Okay, give yourselves a kick in the rear. Put your hands back there so it doesn't hurt. If you can get up that high, great. If not, that's okay. It's the normal. You can't. Okay, let's go side to side. Swing your arms side to side. Open up the shoulders. Rotate just a little bit. Move that hip to the corner of the room. See that corner? Hip goes right into the corner. Okay. Okay. Bring your arms up and bring them down. Keep your legs straight. It's all about the shoulders right now. Okay, hold the hands up there, interlock your fingers, get a side bend, lengthen the body, and bring it down. Now bring your feet closer together and rotate. Okay, we're gonna do a little hip rotation. Open up those hips. Try to stay lengthened where your ribs do not meet your hips. They are open as much as possible. Okay, now some kicks. Alternate. I'm gonna turn the music up a little bit. I think that is, if I can do it from here. Yep, cool. Okay, back to the heel kicks. Okay, you're gonna bring your feet apart again, and you're gonna land on that right leg. Okay, you hold it, work on that balance, land on the left leg. Oh, I didn't go very well on that one. Okay, other side, do it a couple times. Fire up those lateral stability muscles. All in here. Okay, land both feet, nice and secure. Plie squat, arms up, drop down. If your knees aren't ready, don't bend your knees too much. But if they are, go low. Not quite 90 though, okay? Four, five, six, four more. Open up those ribs up here. Three, last one, and four, okay. Hands on the ledge, right above the knees. Rotate that shoulder in towards the center of the screen. Okay, other side. Other side, switching. Okay. All right, bring it back up. Come down, put your hands there. What you're trying to do is push your knees away and stretch out that inner thigh, okay? Okay, come up, here we go. My feet are pointing towards the screen. My arms are up, interlocking my fingers. We're gonna do a side bend, okay? Another side bend to the other side. One more time, and then we're gonna go into our plie squat, okay? Here we go. Come down and up. Two, three, four, there's five. Five more to go. One, two, three, four, last one. There's our 10. Now bring your feet together, bring your knees up, and we're gonna externally rotate our shoulders so your arms are at 90 degrees and just rotate as your knees come up. Okay. Now you're gonna do those heel kicks, but your arms are gonna go up so we can get our heart rates up just a little bit more, okay? So reach up over the head. If that bothers your shoulders, push forward as you're kicking, okay? Either way, you're going to get that heart rate up a little bit more than where it was when we started. okay? Now you're gonna step and touch. Take a really wide step, okay? You're coordinated. Your arms are gonna swing, okay? No, this is not Jane Fonda, I promise you. I'm just trying to keep the pattern of getting the heart rate up just a little bit. And we're stepping side to side. We don't have to loop bands on, so we just gotta go a little bit more with reps to get those lateral stability muscles going, okay? All right, now we're gonna go into an air squat. Our hands are gonna push out towards the screen. It's like a plie squat with the legs, but the hands are being pushed towards the screen. When they come back, squeeze the shoulder blades, okay? So legs are straight, elbows drive back, palms are wide, okay? Fingers are wide, spread. 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, we're gonna go 5, we're gonna reach down. So go down and raise up on the tiptoes, okay? Alternate, so my left arm goes in, stretch the floor, then my right hand goes in. Left hand, right hand. Get up on the tiptoes, raise up, down, your legs are extended. Okay, all right, now bring those feet together. And we're gonna scissor the arms as you bring that knee up. You can leap if you want to increase that intensity. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Other way. So get that left knee up, right arm is towards the screen. Get that leg back. Okay, and leap. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, external rotation, get the knees up. Your palms can be up on this position, or they can be facing each other, make fists. Okay, heel kicks one more time. It's our last one, okay? Press those hands forward, kicks, or up over the head, okay? Either one. Okay, we're gonna go back into that jump squat. Instead of raising up onto the tiptoes, you can jump if you would like, okay? Go down and leap. There's one. 2, 3, 4, 5. Whew. Okay, now we're back to this one. Now what I'd like to do is accentuate driving that heel down to get that stretch and then leap, okay? So it's gonna take a little bit more time. Leap. 4, 5, I'm risking it. I have my dumbbell right there by my foot. Don't you make sure that you have a free area to do this little leap. Don't land on that dumbbell and break your foot. Okay, let's go to the other side. Here, drive that heel down. You feel that stretch in the calf and then leap. 2, 3, 4, 5. If I took my hands out of it, all I'm doing is kicking my foot back, and then I drive that knee forward and just lift up, okay? All that is. Up, switch, and touch. All right, guys, you ready to add the weights? Now, for some, it bothers your knees, just have a seat and do a few leg raises, standing leg raise or seated leg raises, or you're just doing this. Fire up those quads to get them a little bit more ready for that that bending in the knees. Okay, I've got my lighter weight. We're going to put our feet, I'd probably say hip width apart, drop down. If you need a little help, you can go over against the wall and it would look like this, okay? What you're going to do, whether you have weights or not, you're going to scissor your arms, okay? I'm not gonna use the wall because there's no wall sit, but for some of you, the wall could help stabilize with your knees and your back. So here we go. Hip width for me on my feet. And now my arms are completely straight, okay? This range of motion is important. If you have arthritis in the shoulders, impingement, maybe not go up this high. But if you have a little osteoarthritis, try to work through that motion. Okay, almost there. Okay, bring the knees up, external rotation. Okay. I said this was our last one, the second time before, but now that we have weight in our hands, we're gonna go up over the head. Just keep the knees forward, don't worry about butt kicks. This. Bothers your shoulders, then go forward. Don't put the weights in the hand, okay? Either way. Okay. All right, guys. Let's go a little heavier, okay? If you have heavier, go for it. I've got my threes. I'm going to grab a 10. I'm going to put the position here up as a goblet squat. I'm going to go wider. You want to play it safe, like Margie, I know that you have sometimes your knees bug you, so you can use a chair. Sally, same thing, where you just pretend you're going to sit. You can actually sit, or you can come back up, go right there, partial, or a rest. Free form it into the classic goblet squat. 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7. When you extend those legs right here in this position, kind of hollow out, shallow out that abdominal area so you know that you're using the core. And there it is. Okay, I'm gonna go back to the lighter weight. You could go up in weight. I have the threes, fives, eights, tens. We're gonna do standing on one leg. Lift that foot up in a lateral raise. 2, 3. Switch sides, okay? So 10 on the standing left foot. Now I'm going to stand on my right foot. Work on that balance. If you have to, put a little tiny bit of pressure on your toe so you don't fall over. Otherwise, lift it up high. Out of the way for another 10 lateral raises. Two more. Okay, you guys ready? Increase that weight on that goblet squat now. Double it. You can keep the same light weight. Hands up here, both hands together, or if you just have that one dumbbell. And come down. Take one. Do as many as 15. I'm gonna go 5 more. Please give it up for all our amazing vocalists. Like I said, you can do straight leg raises because you can never do too many of those for your quads. So that line, that patella is happy. Happy patellas love to be nice right along into that center, and the quads do it for them. Okay, we've got another lateral raise. You can stand on that one leg. Here we go. I'm gonna tip it now, okay? I'm gonna change the angle a little bit. So last time I was here, this time I'm gonna tip it a little bit. I'm gonna feel it a little bit more in the back of the shoulder. Rear deltoid. Six. Tip. Okay, I'm gonna switch legs. That foot up. Now I'm really tipping it. You can see that my knuckles are facing the screen. You can do the same. Hold on tight with that dumbbell. Don't like soften that grip and drive it up, okay? Lightweight is what you want on this one. Make a fist if you don't have weight. Try to really isolate that. I believe it's the supraspinatus. It's part of that rotator cuff and that rear deltoid, posterior. Rear, you know what I mean, in the back. And one for good measure. Okay, we have another set of those squats. I think 20 is going to be my max today. Maybe I'll go heavier on Wednesday. Now, if you guys are not liking it, the wall sit is your next option, okay? And find a place where you really feel the top of the legs. What I want you to feel on this one, though, is your glutes. Okay, so if I really want to make sure I'm hitting that spot, I gotta push my hips out, but my head is not too far over my knees. My shoulders are lined up with my knees the whole time, okay? That's where you want to be if you want to get those glutes, okay? Try not to rest the dumbbells on your chest. Try to preform it so you're working those pecs, those chest muscles, and those front part. I have no idea what number I'm on, but my legs feel like it's about 14. I'm gonna go two more. One. And there's my two. Okay, guys, put those heavies down. Now, see how coordinated we are. We're gonna put those light weights back in the hand, or no weights, and we're going to do a lateral raise, five of them, okay? Two, three, four, five. Hold it up there and rotate. Two, three, four, five. Bring that foot back. One, two, three, four, and hold it up there. One, two, three, four, five. Now bring them in tight, those dumbbells that is, and continue externally rotating that hip. You have to hold on. Some of you guys who haven't been here for a while, hold on to something so you can just focus on those abductors of your hip. Okay, now that leg goes down, but my foot is not there, and I'm gonna lift it up. Lift. This is a side leg raise. Six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Okay, let's switch sides. Here we go. Classic lateral raise, five of them, and hold it. Two, three, four, five, hold them up there, externally rotate. Two, three, four, five. Five to go. Four, three, two, one, one, two, three, four, and five. Bring them in and continue that external rotation for another 10. Four, you guys should be feeling those glutes. Eight, nine, 10. Okay, line that leg up, the upper thigh, up to the other one. and leg raise, okay? Normally you see it like this, right? But I want you to feel it up a little bit higher. 4, 5, just to give you an indication of, you don't raise legs, but you don't raise this leg up too high to isolate those hips, okay? All right, shake it out. Okay guys, I think we're ready to bring that heavier weight or holding on to the two light weights for a little upright row. So, legs are wide. Put that the dumbbell into the middle and come down and lift up. This is an upright row, okay? We're going into our row segment. 3, 4, 5, 10 is very doable. 6, 7, 3 more. 1, 2, and 3. That was 10 on the side. But what I meant was 10 pounds is very doable. I've got 6. And I'm not going down too deep, okay? Because this is a more of an emphasis on the top of the shoulder. 1. And getting that stretch in that inner thigh, so you work those adductors. 5 more. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now we're gonna go for the band. Drop this down. I guess I can back up so you guys see. What I want you to see is where I'm putting the band. So on the floor. You're going to step on it, and you're going to go wide, and you're going to hold on to a lot of it, okay? And your legs are straight. You see the rotation, so my shoulder's rotating into the center of the screen, and then I pull, okay? I'm rotating and pulling. See my elbows up high. If you're feeling any impingement, don't go up as high and keep it low, okay? Palm is facing you. So my palm is facing my leg, my tummy, and my chest, okay? With the band, you go higher reps. We're gonna double this and go to 16. Four more. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, where we're feeling it. Top of the shoulder, and the deltoid, right smack dab, mid-delt, and those rhomboids, okay? That's what we're hitting. So the other side. Wide stance so you get range of motion, okay? All right, my hand is on the other side. Palm is facing my leg, and I'm rotating, okay? Almost like starting a lawnmower back in the old days. I think this was the original, and then I think it was a starter switch, and I know that because I used to mow lawns, and we had a go-kart that had like a lawnmower engine, but it had a starter switch on it. Damn thing never worked. But when it did, it was a lot of fun down in the alleys, through the alleys, neighbors, damn Clark kids, and take a rest. Okay, now let's focus more now to the mid and larger group of those back muscles so the band temporarily goes away. Grab like 10 or more if you can. Grab what you have. We're going to do a seated row, okay? Let's incorporate this with a mountain climber to get our heart rate back up a little bit. We're gonna go both hands, both arms, and then into the mountain climber, okay. 2, 3, 4. Once we accomplish this one, we will do a few Russian twists and then we will get to the floor. Three more. 1, two, three, other side. I will do this way just so you can see the angle. So if it's in my right hand, my right foot is back, my left foot's in front, okay? My left hand on my knee, and my palms. My palms facing each other, facing in, three, four, five to go. One, two, three, four, and there's my 15. Okay, guys, mountain climbers. And Mary, Paul, Wendy, down on the floor to do it. When you finish it, 15, do a push-up, and then pop back up, and you got your bent row. For the rest of us, or any of you, feel free to get down on the floor to do the mountain climbers. Use your chair or a countertop and do it this way. Leslie, you can be doing them on the floor, and you can increase, but on the floor is a little bit more aggressive. On the shoulders, there's a little bit of movement that's going on, and so if your shoulders are part of your weak link, then do them on the chair and slow it down so they have a chance to control that movement, okay? All right, we're going back to the bent row. Increase the weight. And hold. Two, three, four. I am halfway. 9, 10, 11. Other side. Five to go. Okay, this time it's the push-ups. So do 5 push-ups, mountain climb if you're doing this stuff on the floor. So go for your 5 push-ups, mountain climbers, and then meet me on the mat. For the rest of us, we are not doing the push-ups. We are going to do the mountain climbers, okay? Hold that foot in, get a strong sense of those abdominals, lifting that knee high, and then switch, okay? Mountain climbers are for shoulder stability and your abdominals and your low back. Okay, that is good. So now, those who did those mountain climbers on the chair, we are now going to do our Russian twists, okay? Rest of you, you're on the floor, you're gonna Russian twist. You're gonna find 3 to 6 to 10 pounds. You're gonna hold on to it. And you're gonna keep your arms straight, and you're gonna rotate. Okay, don't lean too far back if you've got a hip replacement, and don't lift your legs up if you have a hip replacement. Keep them down and rotate, okay? If you feel this in your back, then you're gonna drop it down low, okay? 2, 3, 4, you see, it looks, I look to tap it close to the hip on each side. For those of you on the floor, you can definitely pick your feet up if you don't have that hip replacement. You got your own born with hips, then you can pick those feet up and go here and try it in this position or in the lower position. Wood chairs are not the most comfortable. That's why I'm putting my feet down. I'm not sitting in my tailbone. Okay, guys, that's plenty. We're gonna make our way to the floor. Band dumbbells to the floor. If you need support for your back, you can put your feet on the chair. You can put your feet on the ball. Mary, you don't need that. I know you have a stability ball, but you don't need to put your feet over it because your back is strong. But it does help for some of you who feel it in your, who have trouble feeling it in your abdominals when we do the crunches. Okay, we need a sip of water. Hopefully that person who just texted me. So you're gonna start with a pelvic tilt. Hopefully Sarah, you got in. Okay guys, start with your pelvic tilts. Just see who that is later. Okay, here we go. Okay, got your pelvic tilts down. Roll your knees up into your chest. Put your feet down and roll into the side. Okay, we're gonna open up that back. Okay, let's go to the other side. Roll your legs to the other side. All right, guys, we're ready to do more abdominals, okay? We're gonna start with the basics, where we're gonna, legs are straight. That's really not basics, but it does work and isolate a smaller muscle group. Once we get that going, then we're gonna bring our knees up and make it a little bit more intense. So come up, try to get those shoulders off the floor. Suck it in, hip bone to hip bone. Hold on to that head so you don't stress that neck out. Let's go 10 more. So the goal for me is always at least 100 crunches. Well, I try to go to the 20 and vary it. But there's days where we've done more than 100 for sure. Because my counting isn't quite as accurate as some of you. Okay, bring your feet close to you. Bend those knees and raise those hips up. Okay, arms are up over the head or in front of you, lined up with your chest. Tuck the scapula in, okay? And just keep it there. That chin in, feel the stretch in your neck, squeeze those glutes, feel those hamstrings. There's nothing wrong with just a simple bridge. It does more to us than you really know without really having a lot of effort with this. They're not hard, but they go a long way in helping stabilize that low back. Okay, bring it down. Now, your hands are on your legs. Bring your feet out wider than your hips. And you're gonna slide your hands up to the top, okay? Margie, hold on to your head with one hand and let the other hand slide up. Joan, probably the same. We've got 10 to go, guys. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Feel it right smack dab in the middle of the tummy and along the sides. And take a rest. Now, grab your band, put it across your hips. Hold it tight. Put those hands down on the floor. Tuck those shoulders in. Feet are together. Okay, knees are almost together. And push your hips up into that bridge, okay? And back up. Use the band to make the bridge harder. Resist it. Three to go. One, two, three. three. Okay, reposition your hands. Walk them up closer. Now they're off the mat, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna try to put them back on the mat, okay? Push, downward, make fists, demand, stronger, glutes and low back and shoulders. Punch those hands down. Hips are up high. And come on down. All right, now your feet are up in the air. Band is still in the hands, okay? What you're going to do is you're gonna open it up. Okay, I'm gonna double it so you can see what I'm actually doing. So I'm gonna make it a little harder on myself. For the sake of you all, I'm gonna pull up, okay? I'm holding it tight and I'm gonna drop my toes down and lift up, okay? If that back is not ready for it, just drop your toes and bring your knees to your chest. Okay? Keep going. We've got eight to go, okay? Pull those bands. You should feel this in the rear deltoid. Tuck that chin in. Keep your neck neutral. Go four more. One, two, three. And there's our 20. Okay, guys. Take a rest on the shoulders. Now it's chest time. So lightweight, heavyweight, do what you think you can. We're gonna do this set in a bridge, but I know that we've only done 60 crunches. We've got some to go, right? We'll do it in between. This one is for getting more range of motion for this chest. So we're gonna raise our hips up to get a little bit more room for our arms to go a little lower, okay? I have a big bend in my elbows. I'm not completely straight because I'm going heavy. I'm gonna go for 15, okay? My palms are facing each other the whole time. My palms are parallel to the ceiling. And I'm driving it up. 15 for yourself, or a little more if you know you can do it. If you've got the time, because I'm not quite there yet. A few more. Okay, now. Bring those hips down, bring the dumbbells down. I'm gonna scoot over just a little bit. My hand doesn't get to go that full range. Okay, so, crunches. Cool. Now we did this one and we lifted up. So now it's time for us to bring in the shoulders. If you don't want to bring in your neck, where you lift up, then put your hands over your head, tuck your chin in, and just let your hands hover. Okay, get them lower. So they're like this, okay? And they come up, and you leave your head on the floor. This one's for you, Margie. I have to bring your name up a couple times, but I was happy to see you came back. And you can put your palms facing each other. Your thumbs touch back here. Now for some of you, you want to bring your head up and hold on to it and double crunch. Okay, I'm gonna go full range now. I'm gonna put my toes down to the floor and I'm gonna lift up. It takes a little longer, but it helps you get those lower abdominals into the action. Okay, the legs are under here. tuck that chin in if you're not lifting your head up. What number are we on, Anne? Okay, I think I'm done. I think that was 20. Okay, guys, chest. If you don't have the weights for chest, get the movement. The movement's very functional. It's the hugging muscle. Chest is the primary, is push away and hug. So, hug the air, okay, or hug your weights. Okay, here we go. We're going for 15. If you've gone ahead of me, get up to 20. Take it to a burn in the chest. You know, many of us don't like to use the word failure. I have no problem with it. I fail all the time in the muscles. We want our muscles to completely exhaust. Okay. All right, so we still have some crunches to do. And we'll do that after we finish this. Let's go three more together. Here's the one. And three. Okay, bring those down. Now, keeping the head down, we're going to do that dying bug. I'm going to keep my legs super straight. I'm going to keep the small of my back down the whole time. Okay, my thumb touches back behind my head. My arms are straight. My legs are straight. And I'm feeling it in my abdominals. Okay, I'm going to transition into bicycle elbow to knee, okay? So lift up and over, hold on to that head, take it with you. Don't leave it behind. We're almost there. 14. There's 15. Five more. One, two, three, four, and five. Oh. Find the band again. Double it up if you can. If some of you have, lost your band or it's torn or ripped, just let me know and I can see what I can do. What you're gonna do is put your feet up, legs or tabletop now so we can still think about those abdominals after over 100 of crunches. What we're gonna do is we're gonna pull the band down towards the top of our chest. Keep the small of your back down. We got five more, and we're gonna go with a lighter weight, and we're gonna do triceps, and then we'll stretch, and then we'll be done for the day, okay? Okay, guys. You can do heavy tens, heavy fives. What we're gonna do is we're gonna keep our legs straight now, so we can kind of lengthen those hips, stretch them out, relax those legs, but hollow out the tummy. Arms are straight up. You're gonna bring them down to the sides and then straighten it out. Keep that neck neutral by tucking that chin in. If you're feeling it too much in the joints, And you really gotta squeeze those dumbbells, okay? Squeeze them, hold on to them tight. Don't be afraid to use your forearms. And plus you don't wanna drop them. So five more. And bring those weights down. All right, guys, bring that right leg up. Hold on to your hamstring and straighten it out. Bend and extend. On Wednesday, we'll do some single leg stuff, like our lunges. We'll do some lateral stability type stuff. Okay. Hold on to that leg, hold on to your lower leg, and give it a hug. Hug it towards the opposite shoulder. Okay, and switch. Left leg, extend it, bend it. And there's 10 of them, and then hold on to it, give it a hug. You get more of a stretch if you tend to angle it a little bit. If you need to line it straight up with the same side shoulder, I'm okay with that too. What's under the side is a little bit more. Okay, let's bring both knees into the chest. Okay, straighten out those legs. Have your hands over your head. A long stretch. Open up those hips. Lengthen the body. Go all the way down to your side. Okay, we're gonna roll to the side. We're gonna make our way up onto all fours. Ponytail. Here we go. What we're gonna do is a little stretching at mid back. This L4s, I'm gonna open up, okay? Five on each side. There's two, three, four. Other side. Five. Now we're going into the child's pose. Sit down. Sit down towards your feet. Arms are in front. Reach. Let that head rest. Come back up. You're going to curl your toes under and you're going to pop yourself up. And you're going to walk your hands to your feet. Get a nice stretch there, round yourself up. And now what you're gonna do is either hook the foot onto the chair or grab it. Hold on to the wall or something so you don't fall. And get a nice stretch in the top of that leg. Okay, other side. Okay, guys, take that toe and circle it, circle that ankle, put the toe on the mat. Okay, other foot, toe down, and just get as big a circle as possible. Get that mobility back in the ankle. Okay, you can push it downward and get a stretch in the calf muscle. That always feels good because I know every single one of you guys are walkers, whether it's because you have a dog or you've got friends and you walk the neighborhood. So thanks for joining.